Okay, so now, as promised, here's a little more information about this bag. This bag is made by Craftmates, and I'm pretty sure it was for jewelry makers, mostly, because it held several little long cases with tiny compartments to hold tiny things. I don't have any of those with me. I have them at home, full of things like grommets and glitter. So I use this for carrying around with me lots of other kinds of art supplies. It has lots of pockets. It's got a long pocket on the side. I just have some Ziploc bags in there right now. And a long pocket on this side that usually holds scissors. The other thing I really like is that it has a very long adjustable strap, so I can wear it as a messenger bag style or shoulder bag or whatever I want. There's a large pocket here on the front that I use for flat things. So I'm just going to show you how much I have in here. It's a ton, believe me. This, I've been carrying this around for a while for scrapbooking stuff, and now I'm branching out into other things, so there's an assortment of things in here. First of all, there's a bunch of cardstock, plain cardstock, 5x7, cream and white. This is parchment paper, which is good for putting between pages of a book if you're going to be putting water or watercolors on a page. There's just some more parchment paper. Paper bags, lunch bags, little small flat decorative bags, some 4x6 cardstock in a nice gray, some from the dollar store, I think, self-laminating sheets. There's some more of those flat paper bags. There's some black cardstock, 5x7. And just some scraps of paper that I threw in there. So that's the flat pocket. And this is the front side that zips down. And normally, this is where there is a series, a stack of these little, like I said, long, thin boxes with tiny compartments. And then you've also got three pouches here, which are good for things like rulers or scissors, paintbrushes, most anything. They're empty right now because I'm reorganizing. So let's see, I have a box of watercolor pencils, and I think there's a brush in there. Yeah, there's a brush. And then I have this little bag, or this little box. This is actually for storing baseball cards or other cards of that type. And these are just some plain white cardstock, glossy on one side, matte on the other. I don't know. I was going to do something with this. I don't remember what it was, but they're still in the bag. And I have this pencil bag, which has lots of little things. A tiny stapler, a bone folder, metal magnetic ruler, pencil sharpener, paints, and all of my metallic markers. So gold and silver markers. I'll get to these cases in a minute. Here's a tiny cutter, a paper cutter from Recollections. I got on sale at Tuesday morning, I think. And this is what came with it. So this is a nice self-healing mat. It's 7x5, probably. Here's my latest thing I'm interested in, Zentangles, a book, some twine, various colored staples to go in that tiny stapler. Even though that stapler is tiny, it takes full-size staples. And that's it. Then these bags, I got these on a surplus site, American Science Surplus, something like that. I'll put a link in the description. These are fabulous. They don't carry them anymore. Each one has a snap pocket, a zipper pocket, an open pocket, and another open pocket. And so I just have tons of little tags and different sized papers in this one. And then, let's see, this one. Yeah, this one has more decorative stuff. I have some tiny paper bags, some brads of various designs, clips, paper clips, binder clips, post-it notes, another pencil sharpener, more tags, some border things, border strips, decorative borders, and then a quarter inch and eighth inch double-sided tape. Easier to carry than glue, less dangerous. And then this is currently my, I'm using this one to learn and practice about Zentangles. So I have some pencils. This is just a little book. I'm going to make a little tag for each one of the ones I've learned. I haven't started doing that yet. Pens of various sizes, a white pen, these things for blending pencil, another pencil sharpener, and some blank paper to do Zentangles on. Oops. And then in the snap one is where I've been putting my completed Zentangle drawings. And that's this is where I was testing all my gold and silver pens on black. So that's everything I have in my carry bag. Now, I have looked to see if I could give you a link to both the bag and then these little pouches. Neither one seems to be made anymore. So I will put in the description a link to something similar for both the carry bag and the black pouches. Hope this was interesting. Thanks. Bye.